remind you of the good stuff?
This is amazing. I'm just going back to the years that I was here.
So we're gonna start at measure 40. My page numbers are different.
Page 52.
Max measure page 54.
So measure 45.
I have this page right here, but I'll never.
We'll have a question page.
Got it.
here's the soprano sequence, and. Everybody singing, and. That's not what you want. All right, let's choose the bass. Here's the bass, and. Certain amount of tension in your collaborator because they're just trying to always guess, right? Instead of this being assured, where he knows where everything belongs, because I'm not doing this, I'm not coddling the choir. And where he's off on his own now, he goes, well, I'll fit it in there. I'll fit it in there. But I'm going to tell him where I want him to fit it in. Then once we do that, once we have that sympathetic relationship, there's a certain energy that comes from it that's just unmistakable, because lining up time creates energy. Mm-hmm. Having time out of alignment destroys energy, and usually as choral directors, where do we go to next if we don't have the right energy?
Our voice.
We add more gesture, we add more voice, we add more breath, we do all kinds of extra, more dynamic shadings, and it just becomes a cesspool of this. I'm serious when I say that. So this is Dr. Bell's line, I'm going to let him say it. What is our reward, Dr. Bell?
Expression.
Okay, and how do we get it?
Through the hierarchy.
Through the hierarchy. So the hierarchy has to be, and this is you. That's him. And if you could all, you guys can see his hands. You see that I'm lifting my hand exactly as he's lifting his. And that's where we're really sympathetic. And you know I'm not a pianist. You know that, right? So it's just something I let them teach me. How's their hand going to flow? How's their hand going to move? And he has a lovely touch. If you don't know that, come back behind and watch sometime, because it was a lesson in how to conduct it. Mm-hmm. What they do to the keyboard. The thing they do not do to the keyboard when they touch it is what? They don't hit it. They actually let the key push back at them. It's this pressure. So this is why so quickly we can go from this. See how uneven those became, as opposed to I let him touch, then I let him push up. You get all different kinds of colors and qualities from the piano. Again? Yes.
I just want to add something about style. This piece is an apparent paradox. This piece is an apparent paradox. That the paradox is in the fact that there is both a look at through the rearview mirror at a style that is accumulative to now, but it also looks through the front window at what is happening in the minds of composers toward romanticism. What are the elements of this piece that are romantic? What is the romantic part of this piece?
Are you asking me? Oh, I thought you were talking to the group. I think the sostenutos are romantic.
Say that again?
The sostenutos. I think the delay in time, I think, is a bit romantic.
The choir is romantic. You're singing with a romantic feel, and the music draws that out of you. What is the classic looking back?
Yeah.
Exactly. The orchestral part is very classical and needs that coptus and that alternatum looking forward to a Schubert. And the orchestra looks back towards more the 1750, you know, the children of folks of Bach.
Sea people.
Yeah, you know, the people that followed it and were the rebellious Bach family. So it's an apparent paradox. In other words, you kind of have to be schizophrenic a little bit in your being able to mix match them together.
Yeah, that looks like this.
Roses are red, violets are blue, I'm schizophrenic, and so am I.